Super Mario Bros. Is the best-selling NES game of all time. The Overworld theme is etched on the memory of millions of people around the world. But I bet that depending on where in the world you grew up, you remember it differently. If you grew up in North America, Japan, and Western Europe, you probably remember it like this. But if, like me, you grew up outside those regions, in places such as South America, Eastern Europe, and some Asian countries, you probably remember it like this. The difference is subtle, so I'll alternate between those clips to highlight the difference. So, why would the place where you grew up define the way you remember the theme in Super Mario Bros.? It has to do with what machine you did play the game on. If it was an official NES or Famicom released by Nintendo, or if you played it on a clone console. To understand the reason for the difference, we'll have to take a closer look at how the NES sound works. In my previous video, I talked about the NES's 5 sound channels. 2 pulse waves, 1 triangle wave, 1 noise, and 1 DMC channel. Super Mario Bros. Uses just the first 4 channels. The DMC channel is always silent. Pulse wave channels 1 and 2 are responsible for the harmony and melody respectively, while the triangle wave channel plays the bass line and the noise channel plays the drums. We're gonna focus on the pulse wave channels here. A pulse wave is a wave formed by the alternation between high and low logic states. Imagine that the high state is 1 and the low state is 0. A pulse wave cycle would look like this. The pitch of any sound is determined by the frequency of its sound wave. The frequency is measured by the number of cycles per second, and the unit of this measure is called hertz, so 1 hertz equals 1 cycle per second. The A note right above the middle C in a piano is usually tuned to 440 hertz. So, if you want to play a pulse wave note of the same pitch, you have to oscillate it at 440 cycles per second. Until now, we've been talking about a pulse wave that has a cycle with half a high state and half a low state, a perfect square wave. But we could make the high state longer or shorter, and that would affect not a pitch, because the wave would still be oscillating at the same frequency, but a timbre. The percentage of the ratio between the high state and the total duration of the pulse is called duty cycle. Thus, a square wave has a duty cycle of 50%. The NES pulse channels can produce 4 different duty cycles, 12.5, 25, 50, and 75%. Here's how they sound. The closer to 50, the more hollow it sounds. The farther from it, the more bright it sounds. Notice that 25 and 75% sound the same, just inverted. So, you could say that the NES can produce pulse waves with 3 different timbres. When someone is writing music for the NES, they can choose those different timbres as someone would choose different instruments. Also, the manipulation of those duty cycles can produce interesting effects. The music in Super Mario Bros. Uses the 50% duty cycle. It has this somewhat hollow quality to it. Here's how the 2 pulse wave channels sound when isolated. That is how they sound when played by an original NES or Famicom. When played by many clones, they sound like this. You notice it sounds brighter, right? It means a different duty cycle is being used. Why? We first have to understand the differences in hardware. The NES circuit board has several off-the-shelf components. That is, if someone was interested in building an NES by themselves, they could go out and buy those components with no problem. The notable exceptions are the Central Processing Unit, or CPU, and the Picture Processing Unit, or PPU. The 2A03, the CPU, and the 2C02, the PPU, were developed by Rico exclusively for Nintendo. So, any company interested in cloning the NES hardware would be able to replicate most of the circuit just fine, but would have to use different chips for the CPU and PPU. In the 80s, the Taiwanese company UMC developed a series of chips that would clone the 2A03 and 2C02. They were used in several Famiclones, such as the Phantom System, Top Game, Turbo Game and the Dynavision 2 in Brazil, the Dandy in Eastern Europe and the Microgenius in Asia. Some of these Brazilian clones use the UA6547 and UA6548, which are clones of the 2A03 and 2C02 respectively, designed to work with the Brazilian Pol-M TV system. The UA6547 replicates well how the 2A03 works, with a notable exception for the Audio Processing Unit, or APU. The 25% and 50% duty cycles are swapped. So, if a game running on a clone that uses the UA6547 asks the APU to play a sound using the 50% duty cycle, it will actually play it using the 25% duty cycle, and vice versa. That's why the Super Mario Bros. Theme sounds brighter on a clone console. When Koji Kondo composed the soundtrack, he used the 50% duty cycle as the main sound. When played on Famiclones, the soundtrack is played using the 25% duty cycle. It also affects the sound effects that use the same cycles, of course. Here's a comparison of the Power Up Collection sound effect. Now you may be asking yourself, can this be fixed? Can clone consoles play the sound the same way an original NES or Famicom would? Well, the simplest way to fix that is to replace the UA6547 with the 2A03, as the pinouts are the same. Keeping the clone CPU in place makes it a bit harder. There is a post in the NES Dev forums discussing a harder solution, and one person there was able to fix it using a Game Genie. Unfortunately, the video link isn't available anymore, and we were left with just this picture showing a tower of devices. But it can also be fixed software-wise, although on a case-by-case basis. Since it is the game code that tells the APU what to play, we could hack the ROM of a game and change every 50% duty cycle instruction into a 25% duty cycle, and vice versa. So I decided to do this little ROM hack of Super Mario Bros., which I called Super Mario Bros. Duty Cycle Swap Edition. What it does is swap the 50% and 25% duty cycles in all music. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to make the same changes to the sound effects, but this is just proof of concept. When playing this on an original NES, the game should sound like it would on a Famiclone. When played on a Famiclone, it sounds like it would on an NES. Here's a comparison between the original Super Mario Bros. And my hack being played on my own Famiclone. This duty cycle swap made by Famiclones is often called a bug, but maybe this is one of those cases where it is not a bug, but a feature. It gave Famiclones a distinctive sound that is fondly remembered by thousands of people around the world. So much so that some emulators have a switch to swap duty cycles and emulate the way Famiclones work. My small ROM hack was not aimed to fix the issue, but to scratch that itch that some of us have of knowing how would our Famiclone sound like with unswapped duty cycles. In my opinion, there is no right way of experiencing games. Every experience is valid. What about you? Which sound do you prefer? Did you grow up playing on an original or a clone console? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoy this, please consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching.